Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to beautiful Yellow Jacket Field, where this afternoon the Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets coming off that huge win over number 11 nationally, Lowndes County Vikings, last night by a score of 4-3, a walk-off hit by Carter Mullis, driving in Alex Mason to provide that big exciting win last night. Andrew White starting on the hill, going six innings, striking out 11 against one of the best hitting teams in the state of Georgia. And now tonight, another challenge as the always tough Bleckley County Royals come in. Bleckley's 11-6 overall. They're 4-0 in region play. Jackets record now at 10-7, 9-0 in region play. Both Jackets are first place in Region 1 AA. The Royals are in second place, just a game back of Swainsboro, who's 6-0 in region. So a great matchup here this afternoon, a big rivalry we've had with these guys for the past several years, and looking forward to more of that tonight. Right now we're going to take a quick break, get a 60-second timeout. We'll be back with starting lineups after this break on the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
At Jeff Davis Hospital in Hazelhurst, we are committed to building a healthy community. We use the latest technology, and our knowledgeable team members provide exceptional, state-of-the-art care to our local community and surrounding areas. We provide a respectful understanding of care for our patients and their loved ones. For more information about Jeff Davis Hospital and the services we provide, call 912-375-7781 or visit us online at jeffdavishospital.org.
Dr. Kurt Monsiak and his staff at the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic have proudly served this community as the original walk-in clinic for your sick visit needs and as volunteer sports medicine for all our Jeff Davis athletics since 2014. Whether at the clinic, on the sidelines, courtside, matside, or on the diamond, Dr. Kirk is always ready to help. Give him a call at 912-375-4884 or pop in at 22 Cross Street in Hazelhurst, behind Jeff Davis Hospital. God bless and go Jackets from the Jeff Davis Walk-In Clinic.
Welcome back to Yellow Jacket Field, where we're about ready to get underway tonight. Your starting lineups for the Bleckley County Royals in their purple unis with the white pinstripe, gold pinstripes, gold letters and numbers, white caps with the purple bill. Leading it off, center fielder Walker Boatwright. At short, batting second will be Clayton Beck. Third baseman Austin Yorn will hit third. In the cleanup spot will be the designated hitter Shane Knighton. Bragan Cravey, the Royals starting pitcher, will hit fifth. Batting sixth, playing second base, Brody Fleming. First baseman Brady Brannon will hit seventh. The catcher, Jacob Grant, hits eighth. And batting ninth, in right field, Gavin Cole. Josh Dillard will start defensively in left for the Royals. And now your Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets, led by head coach Paul Glass, 5-0-8, wins 264 losses. Jackets and their white uniforms with the navy letters and numbers and the navy caps with the interlocking JD. Leading off, second baseman Ethan Picanso. Hitting second and playing center field, Trayton Webster. At first base, batting third, Duke Stone. Alex Mason will be at third base, hitting fifth, batting sixth. The Jackets starter, Carter Mullis. Jude Worthington gets the start in right and hits seventh. Batting seventh, rather, designated hitter Colby Beach. In left field, hitting eighth will be Camo Monsiak. And batting ninth, shortstop Eli Saunders. Number 17, Dylan Kerlock, will be playing catcher defensively. So the Jackets lineup is going to go Picanso, Webster, Stone, Mason, Mullis, Worthington, Beach, Monsiak, and Saunders. And if you see on your screen, you'll see a lot of young future Yellow Jackets making their way out. This is recreation night, and they'll be heading out to the field to stand with players at their positions, as we get ready for the national anthem, but just keep looking as this procession of youngsters make their way out from the first base side. And again, this is the future of our program. So you've got all the young baseball, softball players coming out that's playing in our rec leagues under the direction of Josh Horton, who is doing a tremendous job at our rec department. He and his assistant Tracy, and I just went blank on Tracy's name. That's what hits you when you're getting old. But, boy, what they do, an outstanding job out there at the rec department. And we've got a huge, huge contingent, as we have every year, for the baseball, softball teams. And they're going to look like they're, instead of going to different positions, they're just going to line up around the edge of the outfield grass. As you see the Jacket starters out on the field in their pregame positions. You got the two teams along their respective baselines, a two-man umpiring crew here this afternoon. Jackets leading the way in Region 1AA. 9-0 is their record. Worth County right on our tails there, 8-0, a half game back. Fitzgerald at 4-3 checks in. And Dodge County in the fourth spot, 5-4, both of those four games back. Berrien County Rebels sitting in the fifth spot, 1-6. Cook County is at 0-4, 6.5 games back. And bringing up the rear will be Sumter County, 0-10, 9.5 games out of the leading Jackets. Cook is playing at Dodge this afternoon, weather permitting. On Monday, Fitzgerald defeated Berrien by a score of 4-2. Worth County shut out Sumter County by a score of 18-0. And there you see all of the rec teams and their coaches as they ring the infield. And you hear the Dr. David Stapleton completing the pregame introductions. And we'll have the national anthem, Mitch's Pharmacy field condition report. We got heavy overcast skies and a threat of a bit of a rain this afternoon. Very, very light breeze that should have no effect on the game unless things kind of get out of hand. If this storm cell that they say is showing up on radar that be here right about 6 o'clock. They had a little bit of shower hit us during pregame warm-ups, but right now there's no rain. The lights are on as the skies are overcast, but we're going to try to get in some great baseball this afternoon with the Blackley County Royals taking off the Jeff Davis Yellow Jackets. And I said, if you missed that game yesterday, go back on YouTube and look it up and take a watch and at least watch the last couple of innings. Jackets went into the seventh with a one-run lead, 3-2. The Vikings scored a run to tie it, and then trying to score the go-ahead run, a ground ball to short. Eli Saunders fired a shot into home plate. Dylan Carlock, the catcher, had to make a big stretch there to get the force at home to keep us tied. And then Alex Mason led off the bottom of the seventh with a single. Went to second on a stolen base. And then Carter Mullis ripped one down the third base line to drive him in for the walk-off game winner. Let's pause here for our national anthem. your national anthem here from Yellow Jacket Field. Let's take a break before they start the game. This is the Jeff Davis Hospital Baseball Network.
Need salvage parts for your new or late model car or truck? Then you should call McCarty Auto Parts, where parts arrive daily, Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, at their location at 118 Ottawa Hall Road in Hazelhurst. Check out their inventory online 24/7 at McCartyAuto.com. If they don't have the parts you need, they'll find it. Call McCarty Auto Parts in Hazelhurst for all your salvage part needs. 1-800-329-7258. Go Jackets!
Make the switch to Mitch. Visit Designs and More by Brandy, located inside Mitch's Pharmacy. Brandy offers all occasion flowers, silk, and fresh. Shop Designs and More by Brandy for gift baskets for that special someone, shoes by Corky, and jacket t-shirts for the entire family. Located at 5 East Coffee Street in Hazelhurst, open 9 to 6 Monday through Friday and 9 to 12 on Saturday. Give them a call at 912-699-3784 and follow them on Facebook.
Go Jackets!
Getting set for action this afternoon. Let's get you the defense for the Yellow Jackets. Outfield left to right, Camden Mansiak, Trayton Webster, and Jude Worthington. Around the horn, third to first, Alex Mason, Eli Saunders, Ethan Picanto, and Duke Stone. Behind the dish, Dylan Kerlock. And on the mound, last night's walk-off hero, Carter Mullis, gets the start. He's 2-1 on the year, 2.47 ERA. 17 innings pitched, 12 hits, 6 runs, 6 earned, 6 walks, and 22 strikeouts. The senior right-hander doesn't throw it hard, but everything's got a wrinkle in it. Nothing straight. Walker Boatwright, Clayton Beck, and Austin Yorn will be the first three up for the Royals. So Boatwright will step in, a right-handed batter, as the last of the rec league guys making their way off the field. Boy, what a sight that is to see all of those young baseball, softball players. And that's our future right there, getting all of their training in down in the rec department. And what a great, great program we have there. And we get a weather siren, and it looks like we're going to have to get off the field. A lightning warning here. I got a weather station over at the football stadium, so the weather alert siren means we're going to have to take a short break here before we get started, as it just started doing warm-ups. So bear with us as we wait through this weather delay.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen, please feel free to go to your vehicle if you feel more comfortable or safer there. As long as you have a ticket stub, you will be allowed to be in.